In this video, we will study about fabrication of optical fibers. Instead of directly drawing optical fibers, we will use the preform method. So what is this preform? Preform is a cylindrical structure with diameter of 25 mm. It consists of silica composition. So basically it is a glass rod. In this preform, the core and cladding are both formed together at the same time. As we all know, core has greater refractive index than cladding. So during formation, we need to vary the refractive index, for which we use dopant materials. We change the percentage of dopant materials during the preform formation so that we get core and cladding with different refractive indexes. So preform, how is it formed? Soot is deposited on a glass rod. There is a glass rod on which soot is deposited. And soot is nothing but small particles of pure silica. So we have four methods. One is outside vapor deposition, in which the preform is formed outside the glass rod. Then vapor phase axial deposition, where the deposition of soot takes place axially. Modified chemical vapor deposition, in which the soot is deposited inside the glass tube. And plasma chemical vapor deposition, where plasma is used for the whole process. So first we will study about outside vapor deposition. Now in this diagram we can see there is a ceramic rod. Now we will keep on rotating this ceramic rod, and there is a burner, and soot is formed on the ceramic rod. So firstly, there are metal halide vapors like SiCl4, GeCl4 and BCl3. These are metal halide vapors which react with O2 with the help of hot flame. So here we can see there is a burner. Herein they react together and soot is formed. Now this soot preform, as we call it, is deposited on rotating ceramic rod. Now this rotating ceramic rod is called as mandrel. So the soot preform is deposited on rotating ceramic rod called mandrel. Now this deposition of soot takes place layer by layer. And the ceramic rod keeps on rotating so that it is evenly deposited on all sides. Now as we studied earlier, by changing the percentage of dopant material, the refractive index can be adjusted so that different layers of core and cladding can be formed. Now once the preform is formed on the glass rod, it is removed from the rod and placed in a high temperature furnace, wherein this preform is converted into solid mass material. Now the process wherein the preform is placed in furnace and converted to solid mass material is known as sintering. After sintering, we get a solid mass material from which we can draw strands of fibers easily. So related to this, the second method is modified chemical vapor deposition. Now earlier we saw in outside vapor deposition, the soot was deposited outside the ceramic tube. Herein we have a glass tube, as you can see here, inside which the soot is deposited. So let us look at this diagram. Now we have a glass chamber. Here some pure liquid reactant is kept. Inert gas is reacted with it, and then the vapors are given to this glass tube. So firstly, this is known as inside deposition. It's just opposite of what we did earlier, outside deposition. This is inside deposition. There is a glass tube mounted on a lathe which is rotating. You can see this glass tube, it is mounted on a lathe, and it a lathe for securing it in a place, and then it is rotated. So firstly, we have a glass chamber. In this glass chamber, pure liquid reactants are kept. Inert gases are sent into this glass chambers, and inert gases are added to it, and vapors are formed when inert gases and pure liquid reactants react. So in this gas chamber, we have the pure liquid reactant to which the inert gas is added. After adding the react, and some vapors are formed. Now these vapors are sent into this tube. There's a tube, glass tube, as you can see, in which the reactant gas plus the vapor, inert gas plus reactant vapor are added. You can see now there's a burner here. Now earlier we used a simple burner. Here there is a specific burner we are using. It's oxyhydrogen flame, and this burner, it will move back and forth. So why do we need to move it back and forth? Because we have to form the suit. The suit deposition has to take place evenly all throughout the glass tube. So the burner will move back and forth. Now, after the inert gases are added to the pure liquid reactants, we form vapors. Then these vapors are sent into the silica tube. And this silica tube is heated using oxyhydrogen flame. And this flame is kept moving back and forth. Then soot is deposited on inside walls of the tube. Okay, soot deposition takes place here, as you can see. Then here the advantage of this method is sintering also takes place inside. Like in this method, outside vapor deposition, what we did was after the soot preform was deposited, we removed it from the rod. The preform was removed it from the rod and placed in a high temperature furnace, and sintering took place separately. But here the sintering also takes place inside the tube. So the soot is deposited on inside walls of the tube and sintering takes place inside. Again, the refractive indexes need to be adjusted so that the core and cladding two layers can be formed. Core with more refractive index than cladding. In earlier method, we varied the percentage of dopant materials to adjust the refractive index. What we'll do here is we will adjust mixture of chemical vapors, because we are using chemical vapors. After inert gas and pure liquid reactants are reacting, we get chemical vapors. So we need to change the mixture of the chemical vapors accordingly to get the desired refractive index. After adjusting the refractive index, we'll get the core and cladding with different indexes respectively. Now after the deposition and sintering takes place, all we need to do is we need to heat the tube to 1900 degrees Celsius so that the tube outside collapses and we get the solid glass rod from inside, which is our preform from which fiber optics cable can be drawn. Thank you.